quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three.
Jason Myers to kick off.
The Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Out there for their next drive. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. I mean, I have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they took their offensive guys. Come get a little bit closer this time.
Closer.
Yeah, but, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
First and 10, it's Ryan. He's got it. Got his man on the end around. Complete. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Smith. And he's going to be met at about the 43. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
On second and 7, Ryan. And a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Ryan gonna get this complete to Hurst, and he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
10 yards.
They go back to the ground now with Smith. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. An 8-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons will extend their lead. Circle that drive because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
McCoo able to connect on the extra point, and that pushes the lead up to 11.
Sterling Hoffrichter.
Now following the touchdown, Hoffrichter to kick off.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things work well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Looking to throw again on second down. Wilson, that's complete to Disley, the tight end. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49.
It's a gain.
That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. From the shotgun, Wilson. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. Dancing to his left. And he's taken down, trying to do a little
too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Grady Jarrett making his presence felt. He gets the sack. Wilson and the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. Now it's Wilson.
Incomplete.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. Here we go on fourth with Wilson. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 18. And a great return as he takes us up just shy of the 45.
Well, that's a draw killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Good drive last time, really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball. I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
That's good for 28 yards. Is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So first and 10 now from the 30. On the carry, here's Smith. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5. After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5.
A gain of 5 brings up second and 5 at the Seahawks 24-yard line.
Complete. And he'll get it down this time to the 17.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things they consider safe.
And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
Throwing on second and 8. Ryan. Intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked up by DJ Reed. Very good return as he'll take it all the way up to the 40-yard line. That is the play they needed in a two-score game here in the fourth quarter.
No doubt about it. They did what they had to do to give themselves a chance to get back into the game. They turned it over to the offense. They are now in charge.
Now they need to execute. Here's Wilson, eluding the pressure right. This one into the hands of Metcalf. And he'll go out of bounds, making it all the way down to the 5. A big play that time for the Seahawks. 55 yards. Well, that didn't take long. One play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation.
Now Wilson,
under pressure again, and down he goes again.
Yeah, offensive coaches always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. They put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed.
Two straight sacks have them backed up now for a third and goal.
Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They've got a third and goal now as they try to punch in a late touchdown. From the gun, Wilson. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've got trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Comes a field goal team now for the second time here today. From the right hash, it's a 35-yard attempt. And Myers able to knock it through. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. So you knew one way or another that they needed the two scores. They get the easy one out of the way. Now they'll get the ball back, hopefully.
Yeah, and the question is, how do you accomplish that? Do you onside kick it? Well, since you have all three timeouts, do you kick it deep? To me, I'm playing field position with all three timeouts. I kick it deep and try and pin them back there.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Attempt still to come.
They'll look to throw, and they don't get it. They tried for the two-point conversion there, but unsuccessful.
Score, Falcons 14, Seahawks 12. Jason Myers to kick off for Seattle.
After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About
set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. And this one now not quite over yet. Still two timeouts remaining defensively. And boy, having that third timeout would have really helped here.
Another example of why coaches really stress saving your timeouts for when you absolutely have to have them. They go over this all the time. Here's one of those situations.
Brings up second and five.
That's the reason we ball for. Circle round twice with the encore. You know, you know.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Keep it on the ground. Smith. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down. I guess he was saving his best for last, so to speak. Longest run of the day coming here in the fourth quarter right there.
And that type of run makes for a better night for him and his teammates, doesn't it? To be able to produce this late in the game can lead to some big smiles and satisfaction in the locker room after this one's over.
On the pickup there, it'll be second and eight.
He was taken down by KJ Wright.
So time runs out. It's a victory for the Atlanta Falcons.